Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.
I definitely, like I said, so RZA, Wu-Tang, did you rock out with all of them at points?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And how was it dealing with the whole group?
It was cool, man. All of them are really good dudes, man. They're really, really wonderful people, you know.
You knew old Dirty Bastard?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, yeah, how was he? I'm just...
Cool.
Yeah, I'm
right. I mean, just real cool, you know what I mean? When they did the Rock the Bells,
mm-hmm.
when they did them, where they're the headlining with Rage Against the Machine.
Okay.
We went out with them with that. So we played as the band for them. So I put the band together, you know, so I was with them through that whole thing. We were on the buses, we did the whole thing. And I had met them before that, just dealing with RZA.
Yeah.
But they're all just like home, you know, they welcoming, they come in, man, what you need, mm-hmm. this and that, you know. So they've always been real good.
When you think about Old Dirty Bastard, you think about that energy. You know what I mean? But I know a person not like that at all.
Nah.
But when he hit that stage, the character comes to play. You see what I'm saying?
You know who he was. You remember? You know those people you meet. You might have them in your family or something like that. That you envy in a way because they are exactly who they are at all times.
Yeah.
And they're going to be that.
Okay.
You know
that's
what I mean?
Who he was.
It's like my auntie. I think about my auntie Carol. She's that way. We look at her like she going, that's Auntie Carol.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know what I mean? ODB was like that. He going to be that
you
way.
You see what you get.
Yeah, exactly. And you know, that teaches us, because a lot of times we hide behind things. We're not exactly who we are. We're scared to show the public our real faces and things like that.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Not Old Dirty Bastard.
He ain't never been that dude. His name and everything fit, you know.
No,
seriously.
No,
but when you're around him away from that, he just chill.
Yeah.
What's up, man? You know, he cool.
Mm-hmm.
We sit there watching some Kung Fu stuff together. When he got out and he was interviewed by VH1, they were following him around. I was out there at the time.
Okay.
At 36 Chambers in New York.
Okay.
And he came through and I'm, you know, we hanging out and all this stuff. So I'm saying, and then a little while after that, when I got back home, RZA was still out there. That's when he passed away.
Yeah.
Mm.
You know what I mean? And that was a hard thing. You know, they're cousins.
Yeah. So RZA, it had to affect you as well. You knew him. So,
I mean, it definitely affected me because, like I said, I got to know these dudes, you know, and they're people, man.
Correct.
You know what I mean? You get to know the real part of them beyond all the other stuff. So anybody that goes through any kind of suffering, anything like that, you know, close to you or not, you know, and then I'm feeling for RZA because I know how close he was as well. And yeah. I knew his son, ODB's
wow.
son, the one that's out there that looks just like him.
Yeah.
Yeah, young Dirty Bastard. Barsine is his real name. But he's, I used to do music with him up at the studio and stuff.
Wow.
And me and him, you know, got real tight, you know, and... he looks just like him too.
Does he just like him?
And now he does this thing just like him. But he's a very mature, you know, dude.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.